Hello everyone, welcome to a Versus video. I am BBD, joined once again by
CVM.
And we are going to be battling with two really awesome decks from last weekend. I'm playing Jim Davis's Abzan Megamorph.
I'm playing Michael Flores, five color blue dragons.
Yeah, five color blue dragons.
Yeah, it's, and a partridge and a pear tree.
Yeah. Partridge is in the sideboard, but pear tree is main.
Yep.
We're going to do the old sevens game to see who goes first.
With a little twist.
A little bit of a twist.
Because sometimes it takes too dang long.
Yeah. So first person to roll a seven loses. But if you roll snake eyes or
box cars,
you automatically win.
And if both players roll an automatic win combination, we re-roll.
What if one person rolls a seven, the other person rolls box cars? Do they get to go first for like every game?
Yeah, this week and next week.
That's a nine. Close. Five. Man, you're rolling eight a lot.
Yeah, we're getting close.
Got it.
All right.
Instant win.
Finally won.
I finally won. I'll be on the play. Didn't involve a seven, but it counts, I guess. Whew, this hand is the spice. No, I think Kurt would keep this hand because it is spice. I'm gonna snap this one off.
All right, this hand's actually pretty good too, so I'm gonna keep this one as well.
All right, we'll start with a Temple of Malady, and hello, you're on top.
All right, well we will Temple of Enlightenment, and I don't think we actually want that card right now, so I'm gonna bottom this one. Go ahead.
All right, I am going to start with a Scry, and I'm gonna keep that on top, and then I'm going to Thoughtseize him. And I really like scrying first in this format. All right, so you bottomed or topped?
I bottomed.
Okay. So he probably would have topped a basic island, so it's probably not an island. I really want to resolve this card. So this is a tough one here because like if he draws an island for Silumgar Scorn, it makes my life a little bit miserable. So we could just take the Scorn and hope he doesn't draw an island. But I could also take. There's a lot of good cards to take here. Yeah, this is a tough one. I think I'm just gonna take Silumgar Scorn, and not risk it and say go. So I'm at 18.
All right, well, we're going to scry.
Okay.
And I think I have to bottom this. Go ahead.
All right, and I am just going to slip a morph creature into play and say go.
So I feel like that's just going to be a Den Protector that's going to rebuy his Thoughtseize and then recast it. I have to decide if I'm okay with that or not. You have five cards?
Four.
Four cards. I also could just use this, which sets him off a turn. But then he could just play Siege Rhino. I don't think this is actually going to get very good. Although I do have two counter spells for Siege Rhino. So I think I just pass.
Okay. I will draw. Oh, that's not a bad draw. I think that I'm actually going to just attack for two.
I'll take it.
Alright. So you're at 18. And yep. I'm just going to pass the turn here. I don't really want to play into his counters.
Alright, so here we're just going to play the Anticipate.
Okay.
Let me look at the top three. So one on our hand and the rest on the bottom. So I guess we'll just take this and these guys will go on the bottom.
Okay.
And we'll draw. And I think that I just want to play this. No, I can just get this Perilous Vault in play. Which I think is probably good. But I don't have an untapped land to be able to use it next turn. So I think that I'll just pass.
Alright, end of turn I'm going to attempt to draw two. Lose two.
Yeah, that's fine.
Alright, so I'm at 16. Untap. Draw. That's not a bad draw. I don't really want to fire. I don't really want to like unmorph fire off Thoughtseize into a dissolve and then just make that my turn. It just doesn't seem like a very productive turn. So I think I'm just going to attack for two again.
16.
And I'll just say go.
All right.
And I don't really want to play into his counters, so.
Alright, so here we're going to scry. And I think that this card is probably fine. And I think that here is where we want to get this Perilous Vault into play.
Okay.
And then I'll pass.
Alright, I'm going to draw two, lose two again.
Yeah, that's fine.
So it's 14 for me.
Yeah.
And let's see, untap.
You have to discard yet?
Draw. No, I have 7. Alright, well, we're gonna be in for the long haul this game. I'm gonna scry. And bottom that, we don't need another land, really. And I'm going to go ahead and flip up my Den Protector. And return Thoughtseize.
Yep.
And cast it. So puts me to 12.
Yep.
Alright, so here I'm not worried about any of his counter spells. They're all one-for-one answers in a game where we've drawn four extra cards. So, that's not, plus we've gotten card advantage out of this thing. So really here I'm just going to take that Dragon Lord's Prerogative and try to keep him off of card advantage and hit you for 3.
13.
And I don't want to deploy more to the board because of Perilous Vault, so I'm content to just hit him with Den Protector for a while. Go. Until he's going to blow that Perilous Vault.
Your turn.
Let's draw. That's a pretty good one to draw. I'll play an Urborg and send in the Den.
No blocks, we'll go to 10.
Alright. And, yep, I don't really want to add more, so say go.
Alright, end your turn. We're going to put this here.
Okay.
Scry.
Sure.
It's just what we're looking for, so we'll top it. Go ahead.
Draw. Exactly what I didn't want to draw.
What, another Urborg?
Possibly. Well, let's go with a Siege Rhino.
Siege Rhino. I think I'm just going to use the Disdainful Stroke.
Alright, he is countered.
You don't really want to scry here since we're keeping the card on top anyway.
I'm going to follow up with the Courser of Crucifix.
The Courser of Crucifix. Can you play to land?
I've not played land.
I think that I want to dissolve that.
Okay. And I'll pass the turn.
And the reason that we did that, so we knew we were drawing it each time.
Well, that's pretty good.
One of the worst dig through times I've ever seen in my entire life.
Tell me more. Tell me more. That's what I like to hear.
I think that we just want to take these two. Yeah, I'm just gonna take these two.
Yep.
And these will go on the bottom. I'm gonna pick up this wages then.
Sure.
And then it's your turn.
Alright. I'm going to take a draw. That's a delight. That was a delight.
A third Urborg?
Thoughtseize. It was an actual delight.
Yeah, Thoughtseize.
I'm going to Thoughtseize.
Jeez. It's not very nice. Alright.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Feels like you've cast a lot, but you've only, this is only your second actual Thoughtseize.
That's true. Protector.
So nice.
Alright, well, I'm just, one of those counter spells has to go. And it's gotta be dissolved because he can actually scry off it. So I am down to 10.
Yep.
10 life. And whatever creature I play next is gonna get countered. Pretty much. But guess we're gonna cast them anyway. So I'll just play Fleece Mainline.
Yeah, I'll nullify.
Yep. And I'll play Siege right now.
Sure.
So 13 to 7. Your turn. For how good my hand was, this has been actually a much more interesting game than I thought it was going to be. I like.
I'll just pass the turn.
I was going to say, I like Voyage on your Den Protector below Perilous Fault. Now, if that was a, if that could bounce any, if that was like, what's the card that bounces anything?
Oh, yeah,
you could like pick up your encase and then blow your.
Yeah, like a boom, like an actual boomerang.
Yeah.
Hoodwink or whatever.
All right, let's go ahead and send in the run.
Right, well, when you go to combat.
Tilt. All
right, he is actually green.
He is indeed green. He has been cased in ice. Oh, that's a tilt.
I'm doing that instead of blowing this Perilous Vault because I want to be able to anticipate here.
I'm going to cast a morph creature.
Yep.
Dope.
Alright, well, in step we will anticipate.
Sure.
I'll take this. And then I'll draw a card. it's your turn.
Alright, I'm going to unmorph the Den Protector. And I don't know what I'm supposed to get back here. I feel it feels like it's either Siege Rhino or Abzan Charm. And I guess if I'm Abzan Charming, I'm probably just trying to draw into Siege Rhinos, so I'm just gonna take Siege Rhino.
Fair.
And see how that one plays out for us. So Rhino in my hand. That was a delight. I will attack your Dawn Protector.
Yep.
So you're at 4.
Yep.
And I'll draw 2, lose 2. So I go to 11.
Yep.
Some of that resolves. Draw 1, draw 2. Alright, those are some good ones. And I'll pass the turn.
Alright, next step we're gonna vault.
So let's get exiled. These three gentlemen get exiled. And I'm not cracking this Heath because I have coursers in my deck.
Your turn.
Okay. Untap, draw. Rhino.
Oh, nullify.
He has been nullified. I will cast a more creature.
Another death protector. I will dissolve. Scry one to the bottom.
And I know your last card's Forge Zone?
Yeah.
Alright. Please, man.
Yep.
You go.
Scry. Sure. You have how many cards?
3.
And I'm sure this is just going to get downfalled too. That's the worst part. I think that I have to bottom this, which is really awkward. No, it's fine.
Sure. We'll downfall it, play a second Urborg.
And now you get to.
Yeah, Lion plus Monstrous.
Yep.
Go.
Yeah, it's a land on it.
Good.
I feel like I sequenced all my stuff wrong that game. Just did not really know what I was doing. Alright, now I get to go first. And this is an interesting hand, but I think I keep it.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep, but this is not a good hand, so.
Scry. Bottom. Go.
I will sand it up. Go.
Scry. Bottom. Go. Maybe I need to shuffle a little better.
These are getting real sandy over here.
Real sandy. Go ahead.
Alright, well, you gotta be kidding me. That is the thing that happened. I'm gonna cast a morph.
A morph? That's gonna be fine.
Alright, you're up.
Wait, no. That can't be fine. Did my math wrong. Yeah, actually, that will be fine. And then on your end step, I'm going to void this out.
It is Deathmas Forever.
I will scry from the Voyage's End. I like that card.
I probably don't like that card.
Good. Sure.
Go.
I'll encase it on your step.
Sure. And also charge up your
dragon land. Yeah, charge up the dragon land.
Go. Tilt. Alright, Dragon Lord Ojitai's in the house. So
he has made an appearance.
The kind of things that we didn't want to happen. Kind of in a damned if you do, damned if you don't situation, but I'll say go.
Alright. So you have 6 cards?
Yep.
Let's see here. So the things that I have to worry about here are Dromoka's Command and Hero's Downfall. Then he morphed the raptor the first time. He didn't morph it the second time, and that's either because A, I know that he has a raptor, or B, because he has Dromoka's Command. So I can just attack with this Dragon Lord. I have a counterspell. I think I would rather just sit. Go.
Okay. Draw.
Yeah, he has a command and then a 3-mana removal spell. He can kill it.
Scry. I'm going to keep that on top. And I'm going to say go.
You're in step. I'm going to cast Anticipate.
Sure.
Okay. So here I can just take this. Or I can take this. And then just have a second Ojitai. I think I'd rather just take this and build towards a game plan. And we'll charge this.
Sure.
Well, that's real good. Your turn.
And a turn, I will. I'm gonna do that. In a turn, I am going to ultimate price my Deathmist Raptor.
Ultimate price the Raptor. Okay.
See you draw now.
That's fine.
So
1723.
I want to explain one thing that I did. I morphed the Deathmist Raptor the first time around because I wanted him to counter it, thinking it was a Dent Protector. But once he knew that I had Deathmist Raptor, the second time around, I'm just going to cast it because it's just a bigger creature that way.
Yeah, it's like, I figured it's either you did it that way because I know that it's there, or you have Dromoka's Command. So like, it made me not attack that turn, which is even better.
Yeah. And then the reason I just killed it is because, well, Ultimate Price is pretty dead against this deck.
And it's better in the graveyard. And it's actually dead against my deck.
Yeah, and it's better in the graveyard, so I'll say go, though.
All right. So I think that I just want to do this. 7, 8.
One downside to killing my guy, though, is I do give you a card in your graveyard.
Yeah, like, I could still do it. Like, it'd be real awkward if it, like, let me dig this turn.
Yeah, it would have been awkward if it did.
Okay. And really, what we were really looking for here was a Swimgar Scorn. We didn't find one. So I think that we're definitely taking the island. So I think that we also just take the Dissolve. Yeah, I think we would take these two. Tech.
Attempt to Hero's Downfall.
I'll dissolve the Downfall.
He just dissolves.
Scrap. Bottom.
Okay. I'll take 5. I'm at 18.
Trigger.
Yep.
I'll take this one. Go ahead.
I will draw. That was actually a pretty good draw. It's a little bit awkward for us, but it's still a good draw. Attack you. Or go to combat.
Yep.
Attack you.
13.
Thought sees you.
Thought sees me. Sure.
Well, that's a hand.
it is.
Yeah. Take Dragon Lord Jiroka. I'm at 16. That is that's a lot of things.
It is.
There's a significant number of things. Well, I will pass the turn.
I'll charge this.
Sure. Somehow I don't think I'm going to be winning this game, but we'll see.
I'll attack.
Yep, I'll take it. 11.
Trigger. Yeah, I'll take this one. Cards in the deck for a reason. Go.
Dragon Lord Jiroka. Draw.
Crucible is sweet.
Yeah, card is it's a delight. I am going to cast Courser of Crucifix.
Okay, you're at 11.
Yep, 11.
I don't think I care about the Courser.
I'll fetch. Stay at 11.
I always do that. Whenever my opponent has a Courser in play and fetches, and say that they're going to stay at their life total, I always pick up my pen and mark down their life.
Yeah,
life loss.
Same. We don't want to draw another Courser, and we have a chance to hit a land off the top of our deck.
Oh man, so that turn I also, I think that I could have just rebought this with a Haven and got it in play too. Okay. This deck has a lot of synergy in it.
Yeah, it does. Lion. That's a thing. I will cast a Morph creature.
Have you played a land this turn?
No.
I'm just going to scorn the Morph.
Is it Den Protector? Play the second Urborg and gain a life.
Every game.
Attack with Seedra now.
I will block.
I'll bioblate your dragon lord from Mafia. I hope that you don't have another Solomar score.
No!
Alright, you got me.
I'll go to 18.
Go.
Man, so you had bioblight and the second herb organ in your hand?
Yeah.
Against my hand of counter spells. That's kind of gross. Alright, I'll just attack.
Alright, go
take
to
10, go to 2,
23.
I go to 23, we'll anticipate. I'll take another Slimgar's Scorn.
Alright.
I think that locks it up.
Does it? I mean, I'm drawing a lion this turn. I don't know if you can.
Resolves.
Concede. Alright, we're back for sideboarding. There's actually a lot of interesting decisions for both of us to make in sideboarding.
Mm-hmm.
For example, I have Sorin, but I also have Elspeth. And I don't know, you know, do I bring in either of these or which of these do I bring in? I'm leaning towards Sorin just because he's cheaper. And I know that I haven't been impressed with Elspeth against the
Esper Dragons
deck. And this deck's of a similar nature, especially with this card involved, like Silumgar. Actually, both Silumgars make Elspeth really embarrassing. So I'm leaning towards Sorin just being better. Plus, it comes down cheap. Sometimes I can sneak it through under a counter if I can, like, Thoughtseize him and maybe he has, like, tap lands and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to lean on Sorin. And the rest of these cards all seem pretty good against him. Self-Inflicted Wound's a little awkward, but it's a good way to... Anything that can kill Ojutai while it's untapped is just very... It's at a premium, so...
Yep.
That's why I want Self-Inflicted Wound over something like Downfall. And I'm cutting all my, like, mediocre removal spells and then the second Urborg. And I'm not just doing this because I've drawn both Urborgs both games. I actually think in matchups like this that are going to get really grindy, trimming a land is fine. And this is by far... The second Urborg is by far the worst land in our deck. Because of the situations like the first two games where I drew it and I couldn't play it and it kind of made things awkward.
Yeah. As for myself, I'm bringing in the two Dragonlord Silumgar since they're just awesome and just very good against Planeswalkers, and that's usually how these types of decks are going to try and beat us. Another Disdainful Stroke and a Negate just for additional counter magic. And then another Dragonlord's Prerogative. We're just going to be getting Thoughtseized pretty aggressively, and I just want another one in my deck to be able to draw into and refill once we get to the mid-game. As for cards that I'm cutting, I was not very impressed with Voyage's End. I don't really want to be bouncing Den Protectors or Siege Rhinos with it.
Yeah.
So we're just going to go ahead and get that one out of there. I'm also cutting the two Anticipates just because I feel like a lot of times the card is a do-nothing. Like, I would just much rather have a Negate or a Stroke or another Dragon than the Anticipates. I don't really want to be trying to dig into something. Like, it's good with our dig-through times, but... I mean, we're going to be getting Thoughtseize, so our deck is going to have plenty of food. And then I'm cutting a Dramoka and a Dragonlord Atarka. It could be that I just want to cut two Dramokas and keep the Atarka, since I'm expecting these types of decks to have Planeswalkers in against me. But I'm just going to kind of hedge and just leave two Dramokas in. Because I feel like, for the most part, these types of Abzan decks can't really afford to keep Heroes Downfall in, since it's just not that great against my deck in general.
Yeah.
And as we can see here, Brian is boarding his out. But I think keeping the Dramokas in are usually going to be in fine. They don't have an answer for it. They just can't beat it. It's Baneslayer Angel. So.
Yeah. We saw that last game.
Yeah, so that's what we're going to try.
All right, let's give it a shot.
Let's battle. All
right, we are back for game three, and I get to be on the play. Oh, man. Whew. All right, it's a risky keep, but I'm gonna run it.
This would be a real risky keep, and I can't run it. One of the downfalls of playing these eight colorless lands, even though we have 27 lands in the deck, sometimes that's all we got.
Yeah, I don't think you can afford to keep that one.
If one of them was a temple, I would have snare kept at Icefall Region and Double Scorn.
All I gotta say is I'm very happy I sided out that second Urborg.
All right, we're back for our six. Let's see if we can get a good one. All right, I buy that for $1.
All right, Temple of Malady, I'm going to need you to do so much work. We will very quickly bottom that card.
All right, well, I'm going to scry. And do I want to keep that card? I don't think that I do. I'm going to shift this to the bottom. Go.
Had it. Go. that was a delight.
Go. God, that had to even be a white source too, didn't it?
Yeah, it did. Thank you. You're at 17?
Yes.
Let's try to run that line again. It's my favorite line of play.
Your favorite line?
Right, let's see a dragon. Drifting Death. Alright, you're up.
Drifting Death.
Oh, you can cast him.
I can.
In four turns?
Yeah, that's the hope. Scry.
Sure.
Well, we got a bottom you because you do not tap for mana. Good.
Tapping for mana is extraordinarily overrated.
I disagree.
There's a
14.
Well, let's try the old rhinoceros.
Rhinoceros?
Part of the old rhinoceros strategy. Alright, you go.
You have three cards?
Yep. I may have kept Temple of Malady, Urborg, double face main line.
Yeah, I 100% believe it.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
And by may have, I mean I definitely did do that. Alright, send.
11.
Courser of Krufix.
Courser?
I take one to cast.
Of Courser. I will...
Let it resolve?
Dissolve.
It dissolves.
Scry. Oh, we gotta bottom that, because it doesn't tap for mana.
I'll pass the turn.
Come on, baby. Go ahead.
Yes.
Yeah. In your upkeep.
In case.
Actually, I guess I would have just done this on my turn.
All right. It has been encased in ice. That was a draw. That was a draw step.
Was it?
It was. Fleeceman Lion.
Another one?
Another one. Third one's a charm.
I'll nullify.
All right. Thoughtseize. Stone Guard the Drifting Death. I go to 17. Your turn.
Alright, I'll take a dig through time.
That would be bad for me.
Bam.
I guess it's only fair. I guess it's only fair.
Yeah, since you called that Plains. Yeah. That was real gross, too.
Yeah. We should start asking for cards more often. We seem to just draw them when we do.
Yeah, we do. Alright. It's possible that I should not have exiled that Silumgar so that I could rebuy it later. But I don't think it's going to matter. Alright, so. I think that I have to take these two. I think this is better than this in this situation. Yeah. Yeah, I'll take those two.
Yep.
Go.
Draw. That is... I will Abzan Charm draw to lose two. And then I'll Thoughtseize you. Go. I did it in that order because I thought he had a dragon in his hand. And if he has Ojitai as his last card, I'm just in really bad shape. So.
Alright, we'll bottom that. Go ahead.
Alright, Deck.
Hopefully you have nothing.
The goods. Morph creature.
Alright.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna charge this bad boy up.
Sure.
Alright, Dromoka.
Dromoka Shake.
Go. Oh, Den Protector. Is that a, that's a morph,
yeah? Yeah, it is a morph, yeah.
Take another Dixie time.
Well, I'm gonna try to draw two, lose two.
I don't think I can let you do that.
Can't let me do it.
Dissolve. Scry. Deal.
I'll also scry. Also deal. Attack.
9.
Go.
Charge.
Don't be a dragon. Probably a dragon.
Pretty good. Well, you can just like rebuy your Abzan charm, then you can't kill it yet.
Well, let's go ahead and start with a Corsair taking one to cast, so 14.
Yep.
Okay, it's not a bad one, but.
Man. You know, I'm getting a little tired of that magic card.
Den Protector? Really? Yeah. I'm not getting tired of it at all.
Alright, Jamoka. Oh, that's real good.
That's bad.
Oh, yeah, that's real good. And you have an Urborg? Game.
Is it Silgar?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
I guess I could take your Corsair. Or I think I just take your Morph. I can even flip it up. Oh, that's real nice. Battle.
10. Yep, it's awkward that I can't flip it, but still.
Oh, yeah.
It is still tough.
Oh, yeah, you can't flip it. That is real awkward. Go ahead.
Draw. Okay.
It's known, everybody in the camera knows what they are now, so we can just do like this so people know what it is.
Yeah, yeah.
Make it a little easy for the folks at home.
There you go.
All right.
That Silumgar was so gross.
Especially since I can flip it.
Guy doesn't untap.
Oh, he doesn't untap. Oh. Its opponent.
It doesn't untap. I check.
All right, yeah, so I can't target one of my own, but if I gain control... All right, I believe you. Huh. All right, well. So I think that if I just send with these, this is 3, 4, 5. I think I can just send with these, get back my dissolve, and then he's dead the next turn.
Seven. I got a 3.
Yep. All right, we'll play this land. We'll flip this guy up.
Good.
Get back and dissolve. Go.
I'll go to 4. Yeah, I'm dead.
Yeah, I don't think there's any. You can you Thoughtseize this?
Yeah, but then I go.
Oh, then you still die to this.
I go to 2.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, this even kills you. Yeah. Yeah, that's
right. Oh, gross. That's Silumgar, jeez. All right, we're back for game 4, and I'm on the play, and this hand so far doesn't look like the kind of hand where we're going to need to hope to draw a white source.
You already got it?
Yeah, I already got the white source. I'm going to keep this one.
Me too, this hand is actually really good. I wish I was on the play with this hand, but...
My hand is also pretty good. I'm going to start with a scry land and keep that on top and say go.
All right, well, we're also going to scry. And... I think that I bottom this. This is a little aggressive, but we're gonna ship it. Go ahead.
All right. Well, I'm gonna seize the day.
Yeah, and that's why I bottomed it.
Oh, that's gross.
Can you imagine his hand on the play? Kind of gas.
All right. Well, I think we take his dragon so that those Silumgar scorns are a little less threatening. So otherwise, they're just actual counterspell against us. And we can maybe play around them if he doesn't have the dragon. I also kind of want to take that prerogative too, but I'm going to take Icefall Regent.
Here's a question. What if I taunt my scry, knowing this is my hand?
Now that I think about it,
I should have topped my scry to bluff having a second dragon. Obviously, it wasn't. But I definitely think that I should have. Because the card that I bought him, which is like another scry land, which is like a perfectly fine draw at this point.
So I was going to play this, but I decided to scry instead because of what we saw in his hand. So we'll say go.
Ojutai. Ojuhai.
Oju, hello. Alright, we'll scry. That's an interesting one. Huh. I am going to keep that. It might be a mistake. Your turn.
I think I just want to play this Crucible to start charging. No, I just want to get the blue source in play and scry. We'll bottom it. Nope.
I think there's... I don't think it's going to matter, but I think there's... I mean, I guess it could matter. But I'm going to cast a Morph creature.
Sure.
Didn't end up mattering, but... it might have been relevant to fetch before you scryed, if you intend on casting Scorn.
Oh yeah, that's true.
But anyway, I'll pass the turn.
Your turn.
Alright. We'll draw. Courser of Crucifix.
Courser of Crucifix. I'll Scorn show you Jamoka.
Good. He is down for the count. And we'll crash you for 2.
18.
You're good.
And step off fetch. 17.
Charge up that thing?
Yep.
Yeah,
two, 3, and then 2 unknowns. Your turn.
We spend land.
That resolves.
I will scry. It's an interesting one. I think that I keep it. I could be wrong though. I'll attack with this.
No blocks.
I will flip it. And I think it's important to attack before you flip in case he has encase an ice. And I'm going to turn Thoughtseize.
Yep.
So you're at 14?
Yep.
I'll Thoughtseize you.
You have one card?
I have 2.
So if he Thoughtseizes me here, he's definitely just going to take this Dromoka. But the problem is if I like rely on getting this Dromoka in play and he just has a removal spell for it, then I'm in real bad shape. because in order to do that, I have to use this and rely on drawing a land instead of charging. I think that I'm actually fine with playing a little bit of a longer game. And keep this drink. I'll score it.
Sure. I'll pass turn.
And then we'll encase here.
That's a good one.
Go ahead.
That is a good
one. I'm able to use the counter to get my white mana.
Alright, so well, we are going to go for the old college self-inflicted.
I have this too.
Yep, so you go to 12 and then 9.
Yep.
And then... let's play as a 3-3. Go.
Alright. Haven of the Spirit Dragon. Your turn.
Draw. Tax.
Another three.
Four damage. I'm gonna put two counters on the creatures. And I think that I just put two on this guy actually.
Alright, I got one.
Go.
Alright, we're gonna charge. We need an untapped. We need an island or a haven, basically. That is not it, and I can't cast it.
Alright. The reason I went for that Abzan Charm play was because his only land is a fetch land, and if I do that, he can't cast Dragon Lord's Prerogative. And he has to draw an untapped land just to be able to get self inflicted wound. Yeah.
All right, we're back for game five, and I will be on the play. And this hand is sweet, so I'll keep.
This hand's not great, but I'm going to keep it.
Temple, we'll scry, and I kind of want to top this. I think I have to... I'll top it. Go ahead.
Alright, draw. Whew.
Just the perfect land.
He's getting real spicy over here. That was a draw step. We'll keep that card. Go.
Go. And the reason we kept this is because we have this to protect our hand.
Thoughtseize was negated. It's not very nice. Here we go.
And now we need to draw some more land.
I'm not just going to play this because he has like 9 million percent chance to have a counterspell here, so I'll just say go.
Go.
Yeah, end of turn, I'm going to draw two, lose two.
Sure.
18 for me. 1, 2.
And a fourth land there would have been great.
Well, he's missing... land drops. I don't see any reason to play into counter spells, so I'm content to just keep scrying and getting rid of cards I don't care about and things like that.
Go.
Alright. I think this is the turn where we make a move, though. Cast a morph creature.
I'll score the really much tie.
It is the protector of Duns. And I'll cast a Mastery of the Unseen.
Yep.
Go.
Land.
Not just any land.
No, it's not perfect land.
So you're at 19 now?
Yep.
That's pretty awesome that because of that freaking Temple of Mystery, you could actually use that my Den Protector out of the game.
Good.
Ah, Perilous Vault.
It's so
that,
perilous.
That is a mega tilt, because I threw away a Den Protector to get that Mastery out there. I will activate Master of the Unseen.
You got it.
That is what we got. And... play one Swift Teeth and say go.
Alright. Let's draw a land. Your turn.
I'll fetch. I'm going to stay at 18 though. So I'm going to gain a life when I flip this guy up.
Really?
Yep.
Wow.
That is.
Wow.
Could have been a Den Protector.
You're right, it could have. That's pretty good.
The reason I masteried first main phase is because I was going to play a scry land, and I didn't. I wanted to not like scry and then mastery away whatever I scry, but then I just hit a Fleeceman Lion, so
lucky.
Just played the untapped land instead. Was lucky. Attack at the line.
No blocks.
So 16 for you?
Yep.
Well, let's go ahead and run the same game again. We'll mastery. Grabbing this. And scry. Bottom that. Your go. Tilt.
Go.
Draw. Scry. And bottom. Definitely don't want any more lands. Attack.
No blocks.
I think I actually just unmorph here. Gain 2 life.
I got a 10.
Yeah, you go to 10, I go to 20.
Yep.
The reason I'm unwarping here is because I'm not going to be using my mana, because he's just going to vault at the end of turn anyway. So I might as well get like an extra point of damage and 2 points of life out of it, and all thoughts easy. Alright, what are we looking at here? So just infinite counters. Alright, so he has 2 Scorns, a Nullify, Disdainful, an Ojutai and an Icefall Regent. Well, I guess we take. Man, neither of these are great for us. I'll take this guy, Dragon Lord Ojutai.
Oh, you don't have self-inflicted wound?
And I will say go.
Alright, I'll vault instead.
Alright, I will.
You kill your own raptor?
No, I'm just gonna draw 2, lose 2. So 16 for me.
Yep.
Okay. That happened. Here you go.
Go.
Draw. Your turn.
Really?
Yep.
Go.
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 I'm gonna do these.
So you got 8?
Yeah. I think I can bottom this now. Your turn.
All right, go.
You just have a bunch of removal in your hand. Scrap. Bottom. Go.
Sure.
I'll nullify.
Good. go.
You have 4 cards.
Yep.
End step, we're gonna rebind this. Which tie?
Yep. Yep.
Go.
Please spend that.
Sure.
Please spend one.
Two cards?
Yep.
Squat.
Okay. We're at 8, I'm at 16.
Mm-hmm.
going to attempt to monstrous my lion.
I'll respond with in case of this.
I'll fetch. Monstrous against receiving.
Sure.
I have a feeling you had that. Alright, you're up. So I'm at 15 and you're at 8?
Yep.
It's going to be an interesting game.
Yes, it will.
I need you to really sprick off on that Dragon Lord and all your draw steps. Alright, I got a 10.
Trigger.
At least I know I can cast essentially every card I draw. May have 14 lands in play.
Alright, well, I take this one. These two.
A perilous vault killed me.
Now we're gonna dig.
That's bad. Bad news for me.
I'll take these two. Minus two.
Nope, that was the one card I need you to not draw.
Go ahead.
Oh god. Alright. I'm gonna need some help, deck. Really could use just about anything. I don't think that this was what I wanted to draw.
Your 15th land wasn't what you were hoping for off the top of your deck.
It's not what I was hoping for. I'll draw two, lose two. Wait. Okay. I'll see you. I'm at 6.
I'm gonna watch tie.
Huh. Well, I think I only have one chance to win this game. Dang, actually, that doesn't work because you have two counter spells. Well, I don't think I win if I don't take Silengar Sworn, so.
Scorn?
Yep. I'll self-inflicted wound you.
6.
All right now.
Whoa.
All right, so you're at 3 and I'm at 9. I'll say go.
Man. Well, I have a stroke for a top-decked Rhino.
Yep.
Well, that was good. All right, how do I do this? So I can Regent tap down his Rhino, plus the Ugin hit him. Well, I think that I just start by digging.
Good.
I don't think I need to put both Ojitai and Icefall Regent into play. I think I just have to get the Icefall Regent into play.
Just think if I had drawn a Rhino for turn instead of Sand Stuff Citadel. I just would have killed you. I dealt 8 damage to you that turn.
Would have been pretty gross. Alright, well, we can stop. Yeah, I think I just take this and this. I'm not gonna charge, doesn't matter. tap that guy down.
Yep.
And go to 7 and do 3 deal.
6.
And then I have a dissolve with the stroke that I'll pass.
Yeah.
I have a dissolve, so it locks it up.
Yeah, I'm dead anyway.
Man, that game was real weird. You outlanded me.
I needed to draw, like... There's so many turns where I just needed to draw spells, but...
Just like that spell, you just kept drawing lands.
All right, well, that was actually pretty good games.
They were very good games.
Yeah. Definitely an interesting matchup.
I think all these decks are real sweet.
Yeah.
Like, you would, like, the normal Abzan control decks just fold to the decks with a bunch of counter magic. But having access to cards like Dem Protector and whatnot, like, it made it much different. Like,
yeah.
You were just thought seizing me, like, left and right.
I was. I did a lot of thought seizing.
Sure.
Yeah, this deck was pretty cool. I think Fleece Mane Lion is one of the best cards in the format. I just
Fleece
really.
Fleece Mane
Lion? Yeah.
I mean, with the format change into just being like mono Ojutai control, like Fleece Mane's the best card to go underneath them.
Yeah, like I just think Fleece Mane's one of the best creatures in the format, and I like that this deck plays Fleece Mane as a four of in the main. I know that Abzan control previously would like board some Fleece Manes or whatever, but I just think the card is so good right now. Every time I play it on turn 2, I feel like I'm gonna win.
Yeah, there was. You only played it one game on turn 2 in this match, right?
I think so, yeah.
That was the one when you top decked the planes.
Yeah.
Yeah, like that was the only game. There were multiple of the other games, especially when you're on the play. Like I was just stone dead to a Fleece Mane on 2. However, Encase and Ice was very good.
Yeah.
Encase Much and Ice better was very than good. I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
Even against this deck.
Encase and Ice was insanely good against this deck. Perilous Vault was really annoying. That last game, Mastery would have easily run away with the game outside of Perilous Vault. But yeah, that deck seemed interesting. It seemed good. I don't know how good it is now that it's a known quantity.
Yeah.
But it definitely seemed like it was doing like powerful things.
Well, so the way that I think that like the Magic, you know, overall metagame goes is we're real slow.
Yeah.
Usually a week or two behind. So I think that if this deck is going to be very good again, it'll be this week.
Yeah.
So I expect to see some people playing it at the Grand Prix in Toronto.
Toronto, yes.
And at the Open in Portland, I expect to see some of these decks. I know that Chapin had an updated version in his article this week with Dragonlord, Silumgar, and the main, which I am a huge advocate of. They wanted to cut the Anticipates completely and play a 28th land, which I also like. Most of the time, I felt like I wanted Anticipate to find land. I'd rather just play a land.
Yeah, that's how I feel with it, like Anticipate as well. It's just very underwhelming. I think the Esper Dragon decks should actually probably be cutting it as well.
Yeah, I think that people are still going to be on Esper Dragon decks, and I think that this deck has a good matchup against them.
I think so,
because you have much fewer dead cards in your main deck in the control mirror. Like, you don't have to have all these random, like, removal spells. One of the bad things is they do have access to Foul-Tongued Invocation, but we just have so many more counter spells than they do. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah, you have so many more counter spells. Plus, you can also play this Drago game where...
We have charged lands and they don't.
Yeah, exactly. And I imagine it's almost impossible for that deck to beat this deck. Just very, very difficult.
Yeah, like you get it to points where you can just put Dragonlord Dromoka into play. Can't be countered. They can't counter the rest of the spells you play that turn.
And you generate so many charge counters on your lands that you can probably play a Dragonlord, maybe even another Dragonlord, and still sit on 2 or 3 counter spells for their turn.
Yeah, that's pretty gross.
That's really gross.
So yeah, I'm definitely going to be working on this deck this week. I won't be at the Grand Prix or at the Open in Portland, but I am going to be battling in some IQs here on the East Coast. And definitely they're going to be on this deck or some form of Green Red Dragons. I think that the deck still has potential. You just have to be prepared for the Esper decks. I think it's still good in the field.
Yeah, and as for myself, I'm actually probably going to be on not this deck, but some version of a Den Protector Thoughtseize deck, because I really think that that interaction is extremely good in this metagame. We saw how good it was in these games, and there are a lot of decks right now where Thoughtseize Den Protector is just very, very good against them. And I think that if you're not playing the dragons yourself, that's where you want to be.
Yeah, one of the things that I noticed when playing this deck is that having access to the 8 dragon lands is very powerful, because all of the dragon lords are very good. Like, I think that, you know, as we move forward, decks like this are going to be cropping up. They don't even have to be base blue. You could be base another color and still play with all these powerful dragons with the eight dragon lands. I think that's very good.
Yeah, you can be base. You can really be anything. Like, I think blue is great because of Silumgar Scorn. But honestly, I don't see a reason not to be blue black and play Foul Tongue Invocation. The card is just so powerful, especially in a shell like this. Where I mean, you can't really play it alongside Encase and Ice, but you know, you're gonna have enough dragons here, and you know, you could maybe play Crux of Fate and stuff too. Maybe it's worse than just playing mono blue, but it's definitely something to consider.
Yeah, there's a bunch of different options. The Dragonlands are sweet. Dragonlords are all very good.
Yeah.
I feel like now that this deck is seeing play, there are people in R&D that were playing stuff like this in the Future League. Just finally, people are doing what we wanted them to do. Just, we made these powerful dragons. We want you to play them. Like, Ojutai is obviously the best of the bunch. Cast at only 5 mana. And I think that we are just now starting to see Ojutai seeing play in other decks. Like, I feel like when Rabble Master first came out, Tom Ross played with it, and people were just like, yeah, yeah, we have to play Rabble Master in these aggressive decks. And then we found that you don't. Like, the card can just win games all by itself. It doesn't matter what's surrounding it.
Yeah.
I think Ojutai is exactly the same. We saw that with Craig Wesco's deck. We're seeing it in these, you know, blue-black control decks splashing white for Ojutai. I think as we move forward, we're going to see Ojutai in a lot of different deck shells because the card can just win games all by itself.
Yeah, you just put it in Jeskai tokens. Like, you don't even have to have... You just main deck it, like, it just wins the game.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, the set is called Dragons of Tarkir, not Lizard Beasts of Tarkir. So
I mean, it might.
Yeah. there's a reason it's called Dragons
of Tarkir. Human Warriors of Tarkir.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert, Dragons won.
Yeah, the Dragons, they did win, so.
So for those of you who are going to be battling this weekend, good luck. We wish you all the sevens that you keep and don't mulligan very much. Thanks for watching and hanging out. We appreciate it. For those of you who are watching on YouTube and not on StarCityGames.com, underneath our smiling faces, you can see some the scrolling panels to check out previous BBD versus CVMs. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel, and let us know what you want to see in the comments. We do read through them. I do apologize that we didn't have a video last week. I had to take some personal time and head out to the West Coast. And as you can tell from my speaking voice, I got a little sick while I was there, so we just weren't able to get a video done.
I also took some personal time and hung out in my room.
In his bedroom.
Yeah.
The old BBD Netflix personal time.
Yeah, yep.
So please let us know if there's anything sweet that you want to see, you know, any new decks. I know that there was a Mardu deck that did fairly well this last week. I think that's something that we should definitely take a look at. But I knew that we wanted to get these decks on camera this week, but we'll have something new for you next week.
Absolutely.
Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you guys later.
See ya.